I've been dealing with an airbag light on my 2003 9-3 the past month or so. I think in short what I did was messed up the clock spring in the car. So today we're going to be replacing that and hopefully getting rid of my airbag light.
In order to replace my clock spring, we're going to need to remove the steering wheel and the SIM. The clock spring is integrated into the SIM. So let's start with our steering wheel. To remove the actual SIM, I'd recommend pulling the steering column as close to you as you can. There's two big plastic tabs back behind here that are kind of a pain. Also keep in mind there is one connector for the SIM that is on the door side of the SIM, I guess you could say. Definitely hard to not cut your finger when you're doing that, but you can see here the two big plastic tabs. They really got to come out far. You got to put a lot of force on them, pull them apart like that, and it'll unhook from here and slide right off. But there is our SIM.
With our SIM on the bench here, we have six T10 Torx we need to use to remove this. There's three on the back side here. I should also mention the reason why I'm replacing the clock spring. I actually was told that the clock spring could be my problem. I pulled this SIM out, started playing with it. When I put it back together though, I didn't put the clock spring in the right position. I went to move the car out of the garage, turned the wheel, and heard the clock spring kind of shred itself. So now I have nothing working. Not only not the airbag, but all the steering wheel buttons. So I haven't been driving the car, period, but obviously with no working airbag or with the steering wheel buttons, I really didn't want to drive it. So car's been sitting for a bit, but hoping this will solve my issue. On the front side here, we also have three more T10 screws. Flip our SIM back over. Should be able to pull this off now. Obviously this board here is kind of the brains of the SIM, and this is what we want to be very, very careful not to mess up. Otherwise I'm gonna need a new SIM, new keys, all that fun stuff. So we want to carefully kind of pull that out and disconnect the clock spring from it at the same time. And put that way up over here out of the way so I don't accidentally somehow find a way to mess that up. Sitting in here, you can see our clock spring now. That just slides right out. So I wanna make sure here, again, you can see this one's just freely spinning because I completely messed it up. And I'll tell you, as soon as I turned the wheel and heard everything kind of shred, I knew right away I messed up. So again, usually when you're taking the steering wheel off, make sure the wheels are straight. Obviously they'll be turned about 30 or 45 degrees one way or the other. When you put your new clock spring in, there's a few things to look out for. First of all, that your stocks, if the stocks are not in the right position, they'll be sticking out here. You can kind of see the little nub for it right here. If that stock is, you can see, moved up, it's sticking out. So make sure that the stocks are in the right position so they're not sticking out into that area. Secondly, and obviously most importantly, is making sure that your clock spring is wound the correct way. So I did that by pretty much rotating it all the way till I felt it lock out right here. I went the whole way back, so that's one rotation, two rotation, three rotation, almost four rotation. So that means I need to go about 1¾ rotation back. So there's 3/4. And now I know that's the center. So Now we can turn this around and place it back into our sim. Now that we have this in place, we can put our control panel back on. There's one thing we want to make sure of here. You can see there's four little connectors right here. We need to make sure that those four connectors fit through the open space onto the control board, because that's obviously how it connects to the car. I struggled with this a bit off camera, but what I did, I have these Harbor Freight picks. There's like a four pack of them for like $3, I think. I used this 90 degree one. There's little tabs right inside here. You can see, of course, there's the four pins. This is the old clock spring. Those four tall pins need to sort of slide through this wiring harness, or sorry, this connector right here. I kind of took the corner of it down there and did two at a time. They're kind of separated two and two. And as I did it, I kind of wiggled and pushed down a little bit. And sure enough, all four of them just kind of eventually slid through at once. So you can see that's sort of what we need, those four gold connectors right there. Now that we're done with that, we can push the rest of these little blue connectors on. Make sure obviously they're fully seated. And then lastly, we can put this piece back on and reinstall our six T10 screws. Not going to fully tighten them. I want to make sure they all line up, especially with that board being so fragile back there and so important. I'd rather only have to do this once. I guess for me it would be the second time. Another thing I'd like to point out actually too is there's a little yellow piece right there. You want to make sure that you can see that through here. It should be lined up. So we're going to obviously have to rotate a little bit, this a little bit, to make sure it lines up before we put it back in the car. But for now, we just want to make sure we have our rotations correct so you don't do what I did and accidentally shred the clock spring when you turn the wheel.
We can slide our sim back on. Should just clip into place nice and satisfying like that. Actually, before you do that, I can't believe I just did that. Need to slide our little leather cover back on. You can see it's shaped a little bit flatter at the top, a little bit more open on the bottom. So we just need to slide that on. Doesn't need to be fully in place. And then we can connect our harness for the sim. So you got that connected. Go ahead and do that. You should just kind of pop in. Once you find the first one, the rest of them will go in pretty easy. But keep in mind, you can see the little cutout on the steering shaft here that we need to rotate it a little bit because we had it a little bit off center when we took this off. So you just want to make sure it lines up with that groove there, which it does. Now, I actually want to make sure it works with this current steering wheel on here before I put the Map Tune one back on. Our all-important yellow connector, obviously make sure that's plugged in, pushed into place. We have our two airbag connectors. Again, I have the battery disconnected for this. I probably should have mentioned that earlier, but that sort of goes without saying. Got both of those connected. Now, I'm not going to clip the steering wheel, the airbag, back in. I'm going to reconnect the battery first, and we'll see what happens with our airbag light. Moment of truth here. Come on. Give me some good news. Look at that, it's off! We actually fixed it! I wasn't fully confident that would fix it. Honestly, guys, I was not fully confident that would fix it. Let's do it one more time for good measure. Let's go! Look at that!
Let's crack the garage open a bit. You can always confirm by starting the car twice. Trick I learned from one of my good friends, Anthony Farah. Alright, so it stayed off. I do have stability control failure still, which I'm going to have to look into. That could also just be maybe this clock spring also being iffy. It's a used clock spring, so let's also make sure here I can rotate the wheel. There's one turn. Still not feeling any resistance, and there it's bottoming out. It's back to center. And we're good again. All right, awesome. Some more good news. It might be hard to tell because I have the flash on, but the button lights back up. You can see when I hit the next button on the steering wheel, it's changing the station up there. This is awesome and all, however, there is still one issue. Oh yeah, that's a little better. Got the airbag all actually connected. Horn works, everything. I do have the stability control failure, but for now, guys, I'm gonna take a win and just actually drive this car and enjoy it for a bit, knowing that I have a fixed airbag light. Finally enjoy this map-tuned steering wheel. Oh, this is so awesome. If you missed the video where I installed this steering wheel, click up here in the top corner. Subscribe if you haven't already. Catch you guys next time.